Hi guys, lately I've been off the video games and heading straight to the shooting range to try shooting some real firearms. In this vid, you'll see me trying the Pindad G2 combat pistol. Pindad G2 is a 9x19mm parabellum handgun designed and produced by Pindad, an Indonesian weapon manufacturer. Pindad G2 combat pistol is a recoil-operated semi-automatic handgun utilizing a tilting barrel mechanism. This mechanism harnesses the recoil of the fired round to push the slide rearwards. As the slide moves to the rear, it ejects the spent cartridge case, compresses the recoil spring, tilts the breech end of the barrel down to receive a new round, and cocks the hammer. The slide is then pushed forward by the recoil spring. As the slide moves forward, it extracts a new round from the magazine, and pushes the round into the chamber, and tilts the breech end of the barrel up into battery under the action of a cam on the barrel. The tilting action locks the breech to the slide. Since the firearm is single action only, the hammer cannot be cocked by squeezing the trigger, but must initially be cocked to fire the first round by manually cycling the slide. Since this pistol has an exposed hammer, the hammer can also be manually cocked for a second strike in the event of a misfire.
Tangkirinya ya, lepas magasin, kosongkan senjata.
Here's all my shots. I land 20 shots on that paper target. 18 shots land on the black circle at the center of the target, while 2 shots are flyer. The target is only 10 meters away though, but it's not bad for a rookie, huh? I realize have a bad grip on that gun, so my recoil management kinda sucks. And I tend to jerk the trigger too much, causing my aim to sway a lot. The instructor was kinda surprised that I was able to shoot and handle the gun pretty well. I told him I learned that from video games and simulators. Yup, simulators like Arma 3, World of Guns, and Receiver have been helping me get better understanding of how real guns actually work. So when I use the real ones, I'm not confused and at least not too stupid to operate them. But of course there are a couple of things that video games and simulators can never simulate though. The feel of the recoil on your hand and body, how you tend to flinch when the recoil kicks you back. The weight of the trigger pull, how hard to pull the trigger without jerking it and swaying your aim. And the real weight of firearms, firearms are heavy and easily causing fatigue. And the danger of real bullets, safety is truly the number one priority in real life shooting. You always have to do the trigger discipline, finger off the trigger, and turn on the gun safety. So guys, my bottom line is video games and simulators are very useful and obviously can be used to train ourselves to become a good shooter, whether in digital world or in real life. So keep on gaming and shooting.